Chairman, New Cities Foundation, Mr. John Rosen. Thank you. And Honorable Executive Director, New Cities Foundation, Mr. Matthew. And distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good morning. First, I want to say welcome to our city, Jakarta. A little bit confused this morning, though. I asked them what language I prefer to speak. They said, if you speak Indonesian, they have a translation. But I think if I speak too fast, you will... I think the translator have a little bit difficulty. So that's why I prefer to use my Indonesian English. I hope you still could get maybe 90% you will understand. I try my best. On behalf of Jakarta people, I really would like to extend a very warm welcome to all the participants, mayor of the world cities, academician, government official, business leaders, architect and urban expert, and also the media. I think you have another session for a dialogue session with my chief of a planning board and our housing department. What I want to share this morning is what's in our mind when developing this city. You already know every city we face the same problem. I think the whole world almost the same problem. I think most of us already know what's our problem. That's why today and the next 2 days, what we want to learn is a discussion, what we want to give a solution, we share each other, what the innovation and what's the breakthrough solution to solve many problems we already know about the city. I want to share here is about the Jakarta. In our mind, Jakarta, you like it or not, will be a megapolitan, a big city. That's why in our mind is Jakarta, we won't have a human thoughts. It's a little different. Like we say, why we provide a one-stop service in our all sub-district office. We have 267 sub-district office and 44 district office. In my mind, it's like a broker office. It's like a broker agent. If you come to a broker agent, you tell everything, they will say yes. We could, we do it for you, everything they know. Actually, they go to the back office, they call and asking. Maybe they find in the Google how to give you answer. So this is the idea. That's why we put all our office, every permit, everything in Jakarta, you just come to this office. You tell them, let the headaches become ours, not yours. That's the idea, it's like that. We already run for 5 months. The first difficulty comes not from the citizen, but come from our own staff. Because you took their vested interest before, they have to bribe the money. If you don't bribe them, they're very slow. And you don't know when everything is accomplished. We have said like in Indonesia, we know a limit for the time, kapan, this was say. When I will get my permit, but usually we just say kapan kapan. I don't know how to translate in Indonesia. That means we don't know when. Just kapan kapan. That's why we don't know when our permit will get. That's why we change this. We put a CCTV. This idea is like a factory. We put a CCTV in front of the staff desk. So we will now look at their face. Is good face or not? Friendly or not? It will be like us. Yeah, you heard it's like a little bit stranger or a little bit cruel, but I think that's the culture. We have to force them. And the second thing we think is about, we need a park. Many cities just developing a park for people to come. But the Indonesian culture, Jakarta, a little bit different. If we look at a scientist, make a conclusion, the happiness index is not depend on how Frequently you go to the park, but how long you stay in the park? So you could imagine in the slum area is a very poor area. If the grandchildren bring their grandma or grandfather go to the park, maybe the teenager fear boring in the park. Maybe their grandma and grandfather enjoy the park, but the teenager could not. How about the pregnant woman? That's why we combine. We call this park is El Petra. El Petra is the initial set, Ruang Publik Terpadu Ramah Anak. We have to say this is a kid-friendly, integrated public park. We already accomplished 6 parks in Jakarta. This year we will accomplish another 54, that means 60 parks like this. And next year we will develop a 150 again. Now the idea of this park is we make a social mapping. We work together with the academician, like a University of Indonesia. We make a social mapping, what they really want. From the pregnant woman until the elders, what they really want. So we provide like a library, we have a kindergarten, we have a, like a clinic, and also we have a, like a women club. So we make this place, it's like a club for the poor people. Now, where's the come from this idea? It's from a philosophy like this. Every household has their own difficulty. That's why they need a community for sharing and caring each other. And when talking about the community, they need a place to do this. And this El Petra is the place. It's like a club. Don't need to pay. They just come in. We open from 5 o'clock morning until 12 o'clock at night. We provide like a musical, like a futsal stadium, like a badminton, according to the social mapping, what they want. Some of them asking like Arabic music, rebana. Some of them asking like a keyboard for the young and for the women. And the other is we put, we call it a PKK smart. PKK is a woman for, how to say that? PKK is an Indonesian. Women welfare. Yeah, this is a woman we call PKK. We put, it's a PKK mat. PKK mat is a, like a distributor chance. They're not selling, so they could get a discount from the factory. Because we know many people could open their mini store in their kampung, in their village. But why they lose the business to the mini market, the smart indoor, like a many modern market? Because they took the goods to sell from, not from the factory discount. That's why they could not compete. This PKK mat idea is we provide this so people could get directly from the factory discount. And we believe they were more competitive because they're more efficient. They don't need to pay the employee, don't need to pay the business electricity. They just in their house, no need for rent a place like that. But that's the idea. First, we want to have a one-stop service. Everything we like a broker, we do it for you. The second is the people need a club, need a place to sharing and caring. And how about the health program? We found out, I found this problem since 2006 when I still was a mayor in my hometown. I give them a free insurance. But the problems come out, why the people go home early without totally here? So I asked the family, why you did like this? They give a very human answer. Our salary 1 month, sir, under $100 monthly. But when we have to go to another, go to the city, to the hospital, to take care of family in the hospital. Even the insurance pay for this family, but we need a food to eat. We spend $5 a day. So even 1 month, our salary is gone. That's why we prefer go back to the home. But at the kampung, you don't have a hospital. From that time, I make an idea, every district area has one hospital. So people could near to move, to take care, and could cook from their house, go to this place. In Jakarta, we have 44 districts, we have many a city. We already developed 18 hospital in the district, in the suburb, in the poor social, middle and the poor social strata. And also how to distinguish the rich and the poor to go in this hospital to get the free insurance card. I also found out this idea in 2006. If you just provide a card for them, the middle class like to buy this card. You could imagine if they go to heart surgery, that we say $15 million. If they bribe our official to take the card, they pay $2,000, they already get the card and get the free at that time only. That's why we changed the rule. I don't need the card, I just need your identity card. We force them, if you get sick, you have to go to the first is a community clinical center. We call Puskesmas. From there, they will send you to the hospital. When you're in the hospital, you just could use the third class room. Why third class room? One room has 10 beds and one bathroom. That's why the rich don't want to use this facility, because 10 beds in the one room. And that's we distinguish who could get this facility. Another problem is education. We also find out in the city, 40%, 15 years and 17 years, they drop out from the school. Why they drop out from the school? It's also the same experience when I was a kid. If I be a number one in the school, my father always make a comment like this. You are not really smart, you know. You still have many friends smarter than you. The problem is they have a bad nutrition. You from in your mom thumbs and your mom pregnant, you already get a good nutrition. In the morning, you have a good breakfast. Egg, meal, chocolate, bread, meat, everything, noodle. You could eat that. And you have to take an extra course. But your friend, sometimes they don't have a breakfast. That's what happened in Jakarta today. Why some of the poor people, when they make the enrollment as a student test, we give them 45% quota for the poor people, even their test score is not good, but still not enough. That's why most of them have go to the private school. When they go to the private school, they have to pay the tuition fee, $30 until $40 monthly. And the transport and the book, so you could imagine, they have to spend $60 until $70 monthly. And the basic salary in Jakarta, only $200. So if they have three kids, they could not go to the school. They prefer to drop out. That's why this year, we provide them 489,000 students to get our scholarship. We spend almost $200 million to give them this scholarship. But we also find the failure of the system last year. Because their family is too poor, we give them an ATM card, it's a saving account. The family draw out the money from the bank. Now this year we changed. They could not draw the money. They just could debit And this July, we have a book fair. We will bring all the students to go to the book fair to purchase the book and the equipment for the school, use this non-cash transaction. And we also put this about the education, the idea about the education. And how about the transportation? I think everybody now in the world, we need to develop a mass transportation. In Jakarta, we have a problem. The owner of the bus operator is an individual. One person owns one, two bus, three bus, and most of them. And they like to, we call in Jakarta ngetem, you know. Ngetem is like a stop in the one place. They wait in the peak hour. They don't want to move. That's why the headway is very poor. They don't want to keep moving. Just in the morning and the afternoon, in the peak hour, they stay. And they bribe the official. We call it a timer. Give them $1 and stop. That's where they wait because they don't want to waste the energy. That's why in the peak hour, not enough bus. This year, January, we developed our own company, PT Transjakarta. We forced them, most of the car have to under this Transjakarta. We pay them according to the distance, rupiah per kilometer. So we hope the headway could meet the headway. It's 10 minutes, and they could change the new bus because they already get the money. They don't need to stop in the one place and time in everywhere. If they don't want to join, how come? I don't want to force them to join if they don't want, but they will be bankrupt. Because start this June, we already purchased a minibus. Our local factory bus carrossery is not enough capacity. What we prefer to wait for them, then we import. We want is a local business running. What's the idea to purchase a bus? I said, if we are poor, we could not buy the bad quality thing, even it's cheaper. Because we don't have another money to purchase another when it's broken. That's why we need is a top one, number one in the world. This July, we will first delivery 20 articulated Scania bus. We also prepare a Mercedes-Benz bus and MAN and also Volvo. We want this number one bus. Japan, he knows, okay. We could accept. But if another brand, we don't want. We want is a proving, or to prove your product is a good. This is the idea. And also, how about the right rapid transit? People ask me, which the first strategy to solve the Jakarta problem? For my personal view, I ask them, first, you stop corruption. No corruption, no markup, no purchasing any wasteful thing. That's why I have a courage to fight all the parliament members. I don't care. Once again, all is okay, I said. But the important is I have to save. You, how come you just purchase an electronic school management system? You know how much they want to pay this? 600,000, 6 miliar itu berapa? 500,000 US. And they want to purchase a scanner, one school, 3.8 billion rupiah. They want to purchase a UPS, almost 6 billion rupiah. I said, no. This year, they want to spend almost 1 billion US dollar for this wasting. I said, no. They said, if you said no, we don't want sign, agree, pass any regulation. I don't care, I said. For me, the important is you have to save this money. So we could have enough money to developing this city. And I asked them, all in the city, they could not draw the cash above 2,000 US dollar. All use a non-cash. And all the employee have to have a saving account. I don't want you pay everybody use a cash to corrupt, including the cleaning service department. Before I could not control them. They just make a report to me, 20,000 employee. I said, where they are? What they are doing, they never give me. Now I put in our smart city, we use a Google map, I know where's their position. So every road I know where they are, just open, and we work with a system like a clue, so we ask the people to make a report. We use a technology. We already want to accomplish CCTV, high resolution CCTV, could capture the plate number and the face. At the end of 2016, we will accomplish 6,000 CCTV. We control all the river, and that's why now the river in Jakarta, most of the river is clean from the garbage. Before it's a full like a garbage tank, because we pay the third party to do this. Too many corruption. They're not doing anything. They just always report to us, the quota is enough. I said, no, all is enough. We take control all now. We purchase our own heavy equipment. We do it by ourselves, more clean. But they still make a little bit cheating about the employee. They're not employee, they just put their name. That's why we put in this smart city in the Google map, and know where they are, who take responsible for this. And this year we will launch our sub-district chief. We have 267. I want them acting like the estate manager. That's why I give them 40 under 70 employees to take control all the area. If have a garbage, have a flood, have a lighting is not good, I will ask him or her to take this responsibility. We also work very close with the micro cell company, because Jakarta at the end of this year, we will fully cover with a 4G LTE in the city. We'll provide all LTE with a free Wi-Fi, a free LED light, and also free CCTV. We don't use our own budget. We ask them, this is your obligation to do this, and you don't need to donate to us. It's still yours. You have to manage. We just want to use the function. Now that's the idea to make this city without use our city budget. So where's our city budget we want to use? We want to use this to developing the infrastructure. That's why we could develop a 7 corridor, light rapid transit. They only need $3 billion. We will use this money to develop by ours, and the rolling stock and the operation, we will bidding. We will invite the company to do that. We just provide them the infrastructure. We hope when you're coming again in Jakarta in 2007, at the end of 2017, 2 years, we already find a 1 corridor accomplished from north Kelapa Gading to the Kebayoran Lama is the South Jakarta, from North Jakarta to South Jakarta. And next year we also will start in 2018, we will accomplish from the airport until to the center of the city. And we hope also our MRT from the south to the Bundaran HI already accomplished too, 2018. But the bus rapid transit system, 24 hours, the headway is 10 minutes, except at midnight, you will find it at the end of 2016. And we also provide in 2016, we have a 5-corridor, a free starter double-decker bus. So like this Casablanca, if you want to go to the museum, you want to go to another shopping center, we have a double-decker. We asking Mercedes-Benz to develop this. And they already announced under construction. We hope this year we'll have a first delivery. Next year we will accomplish. So this is free of charge. We also force the people to use the e-ticketing. So I want to know who they are, what's their income, and so where's the destination, so I could provide them the new route to reach their destination. Now this is the idea, and it's more technical. You could ask the many department could share today and tomorrow. But I hope all of you could enjoy Jakarta, still a really heavy traffic jam. We apologize for that. But in this area, yeah, you could enjoy a shopping mall, everything. I think you could enjoy, another is for the housing. I have to sell the housing. Supply and demand for this city is not enough. Even you get as a manager position, you could not purchase a house in Jakarta, too expensive. That's why the idea is, we believe everybody could success doing a business if they have a free place to do business and a free low-cost apartment. Actually, we developed many low-cost apartments. We already make a resettlement 14,000. They're not rent. They just pay a service charge. Daily, $0.50 until $1. Service charge only. No rent, no payment. That's why they sell the right to the middle class. They save 50 million rupiah. Let me say it's almost $5,000. We ask them, this is an old man, 67 years old man. We ask him, why you sell your right to the other people in this low-cost apartment? You don't need to rent. You just pay the service fee, service charge. He answered us very human. He said like this, sir, since I was born until 67 years old, I'm a poor man. Now you give me a low-cost apartment. Somebody want to purchase from me 50 million rupiah. Almost 20 months salary. And the bribe the official 5 million rupiah. He still left 45 million rupiah. He developing a house in a riverbank, 10 million. 5 million he could use as a counter for selling a voucher of cell phone. And still left 30 million. He said, maybe I could marry it again. That's a human. That's a very human. That's a poor. That's why we put every card when they move to the new low-cost apartment or a civil residence department will change their identity card, the same address. And they have to open the saving account and their ATM become their identity card for this low-cost apartment. So if we control them, if we find out this different name or different address, we ask them out. I think today or tomorrow, Ibu Ika will explain to you the idea how to control this. Another is for the Vendor Street. Jakarta Vendor Street is more richer than the more tenant. Why I said like this? If you find out at night, from at 6 p.m. or 5 p.m., they already prepare for selling a food, culinary, until midnight. They just use 2 times 2 meter, that means 4 meter square. How much money they pay for 8 hours only? 20,000 rupiah for the tax to control them. Another 20,000 for the corrupt official. Another 20,000 for the illegal electricity. That means he ran 4 meter square with 60,000 rupiah. That means 1 meter square, 15,000 rupiah. If you make it 1 month, 450,000 rupiah. It's almost 35 US dollar. If you ask the mall, if you be a tenant in the ASL, not in the room, they just ask you 150,000 until 200,000 per meter monthly. So why the Vendor Street not selling in the mall, have air condition, no need to knock down, just cross in that place and have security? Because the mall asking them pay 2 years in front, in advance. They don't have money. The same with our market. That's why we're developing many people market. They just pay daily. Some of them only pay 10,000. Some mall already want to accept them 20,000. So this become an incubator. When they become rich, they could not get in the same place again. Had to beg to the government. And we also control them, use ATM saving account. People ask me, why you put ATM as their identity card? Because our law regulation is very bad regulation. If somebody as a vendor street, we could not find them. We have to ask the judge to make the decision how much we find them. That's the problem in the city. But if you use a fake ATM card, I could sue you 12 million rupiah, almost 1,000 US dollar. That's to make them afraid to make this card, use a fake one. And that's the idea, what we think. I believe you will find many solutions and innovation in this city summit. And I also hope we could learn many from all of you, from mayor from around the world to come. We really want to learn so we could get faster. It's like we say we went to developing an incinerator. After we learn from another city, in Germany and Switzerland, they already use a gasification system to make a sludge, to make a garbage waste to energy, and also have a fresh water. So we directly changed the idea. We want to use this latest technology. I always said, if we are poor, we need the best technology and the latest technology. We want to do is a leapfrog. That's why we are very happy to be a host here in Jakarta, because we want to get many ideas in innovation and breakthrough solution to solve the Jakarta problem. I understand it could not say many things about the city problem in a very short time, but I hope you enjoy the Jakarta life here. Now it's a full day, this summit, but you still have a time at night. Jakarta nightlife is okay. People ask, tell me it's okay. It's a good. But I'm the morning person. I sleep more early. I always wake up in the morning, but Jakarta is okay, but a little bit of traffic jam is still a problem. Electricity is already okay, but the hotel, the building is already okay. Thank you very much. Once again, welcome to Jakarta. Thank you for the, New Cities Foundation to choose Jakarta as the host for this summit. Thank you. God bless.